City Hunter has been one of my favorite series that I've watched in recent months. With 140 episodes between four seasons, the story progresses with recurring characters and story arcs, but it's primarily an episodic-based series, similar to Cowboy Bebop, with the main characters getting hired by a different client per episode for bodyguard jobs. Despite being much longer than Cowboy Bebop with a lot of repetitive elements, its episodic structure works pretty nicely and manages to remain interesting even more so than some of the random episodes in Cowboy Bebop, which I never get the urge to rewatch. I was kept interested by its comedy, semi-realistic urban Japan setting, and great music, but of course, all this wouldn't amount to much if it wasn't for the characters. Simply put, with all these aspects combined, the show gave me some very welcome Great Teacher Onizuka vibes, another one of my all-time favorite shows. The biggest difference, though, was City Hunter's bigger emphasis on the romantic intimacy and relationship between Saibariyo, the main character, and the main heroine, Kaori. So, one of the most common and standard practices to add twists and turns and curious entertainment in any relationship story is to add more possible romantic candidates, which Great Teacher Onizuka didn't really have. For City Hunter, though, we get Nogami Saeko, a sexy female police detective introduced early on episode 8, and we quickly realize she's the sexy naked woman from the show's music opening, also my favorite out of the other intros, but season 4 comes close. She becomes the first major recurring character, hiring Ryo for jobs on multiple occasions and participating at the jobs alongside him. Her introduction on episode 8 was a turning point for the show. A lot of the best and funniest episodes, including this one, are when she's around and working together with Ryo on missions, but outside of that, she's introduced as the perfect additional romantic candidate for Ryo. You see, Ryo is a very mysterious character throughout the show, as we don't know much about his origins, his skills, and how he got into this business. And at that point in the show, we're looking at him with the same lens as Kaori. So here comes Saeko, a woman that's from his past that's also a police detective. From the viewer and Kaori's perspective, does that mean Ryo used to be a cop? Is Saeko his ex-girlfriend? Or is he just a sexy chick he wants to fuck? At this point, besides all the positive aspects I mentioned in the beginning, the progression of their relationship narrative and how she'd fit between Ryo and Kaori was now another major aspect in keeping me interested. On episode 14, she makes another appearance, and we get some brief but additional information about her relationship with Ryo's previous partner as City Hunter, Makimura, further indicating that Ryo could have possibly been a police detective too in the past. Episode 21 is where the real spice finally comes in. Kaori is almost fully out of the picture in this one, and throughout the episode, we not only get to see how down for her Ryo really is in assisting her with this mission, but we see Saeko seriously looking at him as a potential suitor too, assuming they were never intimate in the past before, or if they did share in a relationship as lovers, Saeko is having a change of heart again. As the show went on, eventually I started worrying. More and more episodes went through, and we didn't get any further developments. However, it was on episode 41 when I realized it was all over, and we probably wouldn't get any further developments on their relationship or any love triangle spies that would have been very appropriate and fulfilling. On episode 41, Reika gets introduced, who is also Saeko's sister. Now don't get me wrong, I got nothing against her character, but with her introduced, I knew that Saeko's role as just a support character was established. She was just gonna be part of a sister duo with Reika, and the chance of any love triangle spies was almost zero. As the show went on, Saeko's role became smaller and smaller, and Reika didn't even appear in season 4. Just so we're clear, it isn't like I had any expectation of Saeko becoming Ryo's main intimate candidate, although it would have been a nice surprise. Naturally, Kaori is the main heroine, and the one that's supposed to be together with Ryo, but it didn't have to be such a straightforward and obvious ride, and it's a wasted opportunity to not mix things up with Saeko and make things more interesting first. I'll go even further and say that with the proper handling, it could have been indeed very unpredictable. Ichigo 100%, the manga, does this perfectly, where you have the main heroine, you obviously think she's the one that's gonna get the guy, but for those that read the manga, things get pretty unpredictable eventually. Now, people might tell me, man, it's not that type of show, but I beg to differ. Even as a small 2-part or 3-part episodes, they could have wrote something in the sheer 140 episodes in 4 seasons. The show had plenty of serious moments and explored serious concepts before. I've only watched one of the movies so far, but I'm pretty confident this isn't gonna be explored in the other ones either. Instead, we got some shit with this random dude. I suppose another issue that makes a love triangle more difficult to explore is Ryo's and Kaori's uncertain relationship, which drags till the end of the show without any conclusion. If it was their desire to drag and keep the relationship vague and uncertain throughout the whole show, then it only makes it more difficult for Sayaka to get mixed in and have an impact. In the end, even though we didn't get any love triangle spice, I still love City Hunter, but it's always going to be in the back of my mind what a wasted opportunity they had with the progression of these characters and how we could have experienced something more. That's gonna do it for this video, guys. This is primarily a Pokemon TCG channel, but I just wanted to get this off my chest, seeing how passionate I was about this show. And I think I might remake my Code Geass Lelouch and Euphemia video in the future too. Subscribe to my channel for more videos, and like and share the video with others that have our fine City Hunter taste. Thank you guys for watching. What's up?